What's good, y'all? Welcome back to the Smoke Your Greens YouTube channel. Today I'm showing y'all how I make a 32 gallon trash can compost tea brewer. It's really simple. All you need is some PVC and some different PVC fittings, and you can see it right here. This is a 32 gallon brewer, and then back there you can see my worm bin. So essentially what this allows me to do is take a small amount of worm castings, like 5 cups or so, apply it into this larger amount of water, brew it up, and then have a great, like, beneficial source of biology for my plants. So let's get into it. And real quick, I wanted to say shout out to Oregon State University. They're the ones that put the plans for this build online for free. I'll include that in the notes to this video so y'all can check it out as well. All right, so right here we have the basic setup for the manifold that goes inside of the trash can. This is just a PVC structure with 1/2 inch PVC and some different PVC fittings that you can see. There are 1/16 inch holes drilled all the way around this, and then also in the bottom of this cap. And so that's what's aerating and bringing all the air up as we are using this. And so one of these sides go out to the left of the bin, and the other side is connected to an air pump, and the air pump is feeding air into the PVC and bringing that water up and bringing that oxygen up through the water. All right, so this is how it looks assembled in the trash can. You can see to one side it has this cap that stops any of the airflow. And then over here, this comes out to a little piece that connects to my air pump. And that air pump is just feeding air in here that's bubbling up. I'm not making a tea today, but I'll show y'all in a part 2 video what that entails. But basically all I do is I take a mesh bag like this, fill it with the amount of worm castings that I need, and then I'll tie it onto this and let it just sit in the water and be agitated by it. I then obviously turn on my air pump. And then the things that I also like to add every time are definitely some blackstrap unsulfured molasses. This is not blackstrap, but it's unsulfured, so this is good enough for now. And then occasionally I add in some kelp meal, which is just a source of food for the bacteria and fungi. And the molasses is also a great food source for the bacteria, though they only need a little bit, not a lot. Okay, so this is what it looks like when it's running. You can see all this air being forced up and agitating the compost. And the idea is that the compost is covered in a ton of microbes and bacteria and fungi. And the water, the aeration, and molasses is being used to, one, strip the microbes off of the compost, and then two, allow them to feed on the bacteria and kelp that is added into the brew. I typically allow these to run for 24 to 48 hours, depending on the heat of your climate. As it's hotter, I run shorter, and as colder, I let it brew a little bit longer. But use your nose, it should smell earthy, and maybe some little bit of bubbles, nothing too crazy. But yeah, that's really it for this setup. Super easy. Once again, allows me to use a little bit of worm compost and a large amount of crops, and that's really it, y'all. Make your own.
Today, but if you want a part 2 where I show you how I mix my own compost tea, holler at me in the comments, y'all. Peace.